don't give me no lines and keep your hands to yourself. Keep your hands to yourself.
Hey everybody, what's going on? Eric C here. Hope you guys are doing good. I am doing just great. So the Dragon Burst Quilted Maple Veneer Topped, I don't know what you call it, guitar is complete. With all the things that I had going on as far as buying a car, running around, going from dealership and phone calls and everything else, I finally found time to kind of get this thing complete. Now, I was trying to find videos. I have two guitars that I have over here that are going to get makeovers. This one here and an Ibanez 470, I think it is, something like that, in the other room. And I started working on this one first. Now, I couldn't find any videos of like unboxing videos or anything. I did find an Ibanez video that I put up, basically titled, what was it, Don't Throw Any Parts Away or something like that. But couldn't find anything of this. Now, this was a darker colored blue, almost like a real deep purple. Deep purple, good band. And it was kind of transparent, so you can see the mahogany through it a little bit. But it was in really shitty shape. It was scratched up, chipped up, dented, everything. I mean, if things that can happen to a guitar, that kind of happened to this. So what I ended up doing with this thing here is I veneered the top, veneered the headstock. Now, the veneer that I get, it comes from China, number one. But it doesn't take, you know, a month for it to get here, which is kind of nice. And they do have some really good quality veneers. I've got some flame maple veneer in the other room, along with a bunch of other veneers that I've got that I'm going to be using for different projects later on as well. But this one here, it is book matched, glued at the seam. They do somewhat of a good job with gluing it. I can't say they do a really good job, so you're going to have to, you know, if you bond it to something, you're going to have to do some type of cleaning of the glue, either with a little bit of acetone or some sanding to remove the glue that is seeped through around the seam. Otherwise, your stain or dyes are not going to stick to that area. Now, this one here, you got three sheets, and all three sheets are pretty much matched, you know, depending on which direction they cut from the tree. They're going one way or going away. And there's some minor differences in them, but they all had a lot of the same characteristics. Now, what I did is I have another sheet of veneer, and I cut this part off of it over here and adhered it to the headstock. So what you see over here, as far as the way it's quilted, I'm trying not to get a good glare on it, is pretty much kind of the way it is over here. The only thing is that I went with a darker color, so you don't see the figuring that you see over here. Now, this body was kind of flat. All right, there was kind of a bubble to it, but not like a Les Paul body, say. All right, now what I ended up doing with this is I sanded this side down quite a bit and left this side a little bit thicker. This side has the controls, electronics, and everything else on it. This side here really doesn't have nothing at all but your arm laying on it. So instead of carving an armrest, I thinned out the body. So you can see over here, body is a little bit thicker side. This is a lot thinner. Kind of reminds you of like some of the Ibanez guitars, but the Ibanez guitars is the thickness is throughout on both sides. It's just narrowed down on each side, thicker in the middle. Now, the middle of this is pretty much stock, pretty much, kind of, maybe a couple thousandths thinner compared to what it was when it had the paint and everything on there. Now it's pretty much where it's supposed to be because of adding the veneer. So when I end up sanding this thing down, I made up the difference, cut the difference off of this from the veneer, the epoxy resin, so it's not going to give me dramatic changes in setting this thing up, or the bridge is going to be down too far or up too high. Now, what I ended up doing is, I don't know if you could tell it just by the way it looks in the camera, but this area over here has a glare to it. All right, this is arched inwards. It's flat around the edges with a hump in the middle over here. And like I said, this is thin all the way over here. So when I put, I had to plug the holes for the strap locks so I could center the, recenter them after this was completed. I was going to go with black as far as the hardware goes. I bought chrome Tone Ninja locking tuners, and I picked up a set of black ones, and I went with the chrome ones instead of going with the black. These would probably be used later on in another project. Then I was thinking about, and I'm glad I listened to you guys, because when I started this, I figured I was going to kind of match the neck into the body a little bit, and I'm glad I listened to you guys when you guys told me don't do it. So I didn't do it, and it looks fucking great. One of the things I was thinking about doing for pickup rings, now EMGs is what I got inside here. I've got the Zach Wild 81, 85 pickups inside here. Now, problem with this is that the kit comes with long shaft. All right, I need a short shaft. So I had to order a wiring kit for EMG, and I only went with one master volume, one tone, and then a three-way. So I got spare parts. Oh well. So what I was going to do with this is kind of match the pickup rings with the body. So I went with a blue and I went with a green. Right off the bat, you can kind of say, look at this and be like, that just does not look right. These are too bright and not the right shade of color. So again, future projects. So I found someone on eBay, I don't know if he makes these or where he gets them from, they're metal. They are straddled, so this one is thinner and this one's a little bit thicker. They're not made for Les Pauls, okay, so like I said, this is kind of flat over here where the pickups are. I left that kind of alone when I was doing some of the sanding as far as giving it an arch. I didn't arch it, I left it flat. So what happened over here is that these are metal. They're made for EMGs, and if you know anything about trying to buy pickup rings for EMG pickups, measure the pickup, buy what you need once instead of having to buy it twice, because not all pickup rings fit around EMGs. So these are a brushed type of finish, and these are either CNC'd or milled or whatever as far as whoever cut these. They're beautiful. I mean, I really like the way they look. They go great with the EMG setup. Now, with this thing here, I ended up pucking the frets, Now, this has no sharp frets on it at all. It's a really nice. Stainless steel frets, re-radius the fretboard to a 12, and stainless steel Stumac frets. And they shine like a bumper of a gold caddy. And they came out really, really nice. Now, the nut on here, I think it's a graphite nut. It's not bone and it ain't plastic, but it is the original nut that came with this neck. And I used it on here because there's really nothing wrong with it. When I found out it wasn't plastic, it's like, okay, this is kind of a good thing, so I don't have to make one now. This one is perfect. I did have to adjust the action height at the first fret, so that has been taken care of. The covers for the controls, the truss rod cover is the original. It had a piece of plastic over it, so it looks like it's brand new. And other than my fingerprints on the back of this thing, that cover had plastic over it as well. Recessed washers for the neck, they're not sticking up. One volume, one tone, three-way switch. I did put a roller bridge on here. It's a tune-o-matic, but it's a roller. What else did I say about this thing? Other than it's going to be up on eBay, and that's where it's headed for. So once I get done probably with this video, I'll start taking some snapshots, other snapshots, and putting them up on eBay and getting this thing set up to go bye-bye and find a new home. I am going to plug this thing in while it's here. I am going to play around with it. I want to hear what the Zach Wild. I've had bunch of different EMG pickups that I've installed on guitars, and I've listened to them and stuff, and I really don't hear that much of a difference between, I mean, the 81 and 85s compared to the other pickups. Yeah, you can hear a minor difference in them, but for the 81 and 85s, I don't know, to me they kind of pretty much all sound the same, other than somebody's name being on the box. Alright, so that's my story. I'm sticking to it. She's going to be out of here as soon as I post what I need to post. And you guys have a great Father's Day weekend to all you dads out there. Do some barbecuing or something, you know, or hell, make the family make you dinner. Just make sure you have either Tums or Pepto-Bismol, just in case, you know. All right, take it easy, guys.